Now let's check back in with Audra Lowe,
who's back on the red carpet with even more stars from American Soul.
When you're working on this project with something so close to you as your father, is there anything in particular that you wanted to make sure that you got out there? Because we only knew the show. We barely knew the real Don Cornelius.
You know, he sacrificed a lot. He sacrificed his family, he sacrificed his health, his relationships with a lot of people, a lot of things, just to make sure that he created a business and a situation where black people were looked at in a positive light. People are now starting to understand just how difficult the business is and what you sacrifice.
I'm talking about a national television show written, produced, and owned by black folks.
What would you say is the thing that surprised you the most about Don Cornelius in working on this project?
Surprising, and the thing that I loved about it was his drive. So many people told him things couldn't happen, and he kept pushing, he kept making it happen.
How big do you think it'll be?
Bigger than my wildest dream.
Don was a G, you know, like, so many times we see a lot of, like, you know, the glitz and the glam of the industry and the finished product, but you see behind the scenes, like, Don Cornelius was getting down.
Don Cornelius introduced me visually to the world as a singer. So Hiram Hicks and Ronald Isley, when my record was done, they went to him, they had a meeting with him, and they said to him, we signed this girl, she's been around a long time, she's been writing hits for people, and they played the music for him, and he was like, she is a star, I want to be a part of it. And the world saw me for the first time on a Soul Train stage on a Saturday morning.
You can catch the remaining episodes of American Soul Tuesday nights on BET. In LA for Celebrity Page, I'm Audra Lowe.